Very good morning, students. Today we will study chapter number 5, that is health and hygiene. Now when we talk about the health, what do you understand by the term health? Health is a state where you are free from any type of a disease, you are not suffering from any type of an injury, you are healthy. That is termed as a state of health. If a person is healthy, it means that he or she is not suffering from any type of a disease, neither he or she has any type of an injury in her or his body. That is termed as a health. Now when we talk about the health and the hygiene is the way of keeping your body clean. It is not about just the body, it is about your surroundings also. If you have to be healthy, then you have to keep your body clean as well as the surrounding around you, that is also to be clean. If you are living in unhygienic conditions, then what will happen? There will be a lot of diseases that will surround you, or the probability of suffering from any type of a disease will increase many a times. Now coming to the topic health, as I have already described what health is. Now when we talk about the health, the basic thing that comes in our mind in order to remain healthy is that we should eat fresh vegetables, fresh food. From food it comes that we should take a adequate balanced diet, right? We should exercise daily. I hope you all are doing exercises right now at home. And apart from food, apart from exercise, what we have to do? We have to keep our surroundings clean as well as ourselves clean. That is, if things are clean, it will be better for us. Now these three things are very much important for us. Now if we talk about the next thing, it is about taking rest. If we are not taking rest, what will happen? If we are continuously waking late in the night and we are waking up early in the night, then our body will get tired automatically, and there are chances that we might fall ill once again, not because of any other factor, that is we are not exercising or we are not eating balanced diet or our surrounding is not clean. But if we are not taking rest, proper rest, adequate amount of a rest, we are not sleeping for 7 to 8 hours daily, then what will happen? Our body will not be good for us. We will not be able to achieve health, right? So healthiness is also very important factor. Now coming to the point, when we are talking about the health, what are the basic components of the health? As I have told you that it is about the diet. Now if we are talking about the diet is all about nutrition. Right? Nutrition, all the essential things that we are deriving actually from the food that we are eating, that is termed as a nutrient or the nutrition. Now when we are talking about the nutrition, this nutrition is of 5 types. How many types? It is of 5 types. One is carbohydrates, next is proteins, next is fats, fourth is vitamins, fifth is minerals. Later we will add 2 more things in the form of roughage and water. Roughage plus water. Now all these things that I have written here, they all have a very important role to play. Now when we are talking about the vitamins, okay, when we are talking about these essential components in the diet, when they all come together, when all of them is present, then it is termed as a balanced diet. Balanced diet is that when you are having everything in a fixed ratio, in a proper ratio, Like if you are talking about the carbohydrates, they should be in a particular ratio. Proteins, they should be in a particular ratio. Like we are normal people, we are not doing a lot of physical exercise, right? So the or intake for the protein would be bit less in comparison to the people who are involved in a lot of physical exercises, like the athletes. They will require more amount of the protein, or the people who are going to the gym, or they are building their bodies. What they require? They require more protein. They will not require carbohydrate in that much amount. They will require more proteins and a certain amount of energy as well, right? Now when we talk about these all five plus roughage and water, they when they combine together, then it makes a balanced diet. Now coming to the importance of these components one by one. Now when we talk about the carbohydrates, what do we achieve from the carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are the basic source of energy for the human beings. What are they? Carbohydrates are the source of energy. They are the source of energy for the human beings. Now when we are talking about the energy, it is not that we are not obtaining energy from these things. We are obtaining energy from them also. But the maximum amount of energy that we get or we absorb is from the carbohydrates. Why? If we will look at our diet, what we are eating early in the morning in the breakfast, it is paratha, or it is some of you might be going for puri or the bread slices. Bread is even made from what? It is made from the flour, and flour from that we are also taking chapatis or the fulkas, right? So that is the basic thing that we are eating. So if we are talking about carbohydrates, they are giving us energy because what we are eating carbohydrate rich diet, because we are eating wheat, we are eating rice, right? What are they? They are giving us a lot of energy in the form of carbohydrates. We are taking thrice in a day. Literally we are eating thrice in a day. It can be more or less according to the one's own body requirement. It is not necessary that everyone is going to eat three times a day only. It might be four times, and especially if we talk about the children, their energy requirement is much more because their body is still growing. Therefore, and they are working out also, they are moving here and there randomly, they are notorious ones. So what happens, their energy is utilized in all the notorious activities. Therefore their energy requirement is more, and that's why they will eat more frequently in comparison to the adults, right? So if we are talking about the carbohydrates are the bread. I have taken the example of bread also. Bread, etc. They all are the carbohydrates. Now when we talk about the proteins, why proteins are important for us? Proteins are important because they help in muscle building. They help in building muscles. They help in repair of the injured muscles or the tissues while we are working. Now when we are working, there is a chances that we might injure ourselves, or our muscles might rupture. There is some injury. So if we have having an adequate amount of a protein in our diet, what will happen? The person will be muscular, right? The person will be muscular. Why? Because its protein intake is more. Now when we talk about the proteins, from where do we derive protein, or from where, what are the food substances which have major amount of the protein in them? So it is milk, egg, meat. Now meat is of two types. One is a red meat and one other is a white meat. Both of them have a good amount of a protein intake in them. Now apart from that protein intake, if we talk about the other things, so milk and milk derivatives, all the derivatives of the milk, they have what? They are good in protein sources, like cheese. That is also a very good source of a protein, right? If any of your elder brother is going to the gym, you might see that he is eating more of a cheese and drinking a lot of milk, or eating egg and taking meat every now and then. Why? In order to maintain or in order to meet the requirement of protein level in the body, right? Now the next is the fats. These are the reserve source. These are the reserve source of energy in our body. I'm saying reserve source of energy in our body. What does it mean? Reserve source. Now, if you will look around yourself, you will find that there are certain people who are a bit healthy. Healthy means they are on a fatter side. Now, when the person is on a fatter side, you will see that the tummy is bulging out, right? And their arms are a bit big, the thighs are bigger, right? So these are the features of the person who have more amount of the fat deposit in their body. Now, from where does this fat deposit? Now, suppose you are not doing a lot of physical exercise. You are not doing physical exercise at all. You are just sitting there and eating, sitting, eating, studying, sitting, eating, studying, and you are not playing. You are not involved in any type of a physical activity, but the food that you are taking is very rich. That is, it is having a lot of protein in it. It is having a lot of carbohydrates. It has a lot of fats in it. Like you are eating aloo ka paratha. As simple as that. And what your mother does is she gives you a cube of butter. And you, that aloo ka paratha is already made in the ghee. But when you are applying extra butter on it, what you are increasing? You are increasing the fat content of that food. Right, once that fatty things you are eating, extra amount of fat is going inside your body and you are not using that energy, then what will happen? It will start depositing under your skin in the form of a layer, and that will increase your size. You will become healthier. First, you, if you are weak, you will become healthy. And then if you continue with that diet and you are not making any tremendous change in your physical activities, then what will happen? The energy level is getting enormous. It is building up in your body and you are not utilizing that energy. Then what will happen? All of a sudden, slowly and gradually, what will happen? Your tummy will start coming out. It will start bulging out. You will become fat. And then what you will do, you will sweat out in the gym in order to become thin once again. So what we have to do, we have to use the fats according to our physical needs, according to our body type, right? So if we are talking about the fats, what are the primary sources of the fat? Milk is also a source of a fat. But these days, milk is not a primary source of a fat. Why? Because the milk that is coming to our homes, it is skimmed milk. All the cream is already been taken out. If you are taking a 100% pure milk, then only you are getting a sufficient amount of a fat in it. Apart from the fat, what it is about the oils. Ghee. Now, when I am talking about the oils, there are different types of cooking oil. You might be using mustard oil for cooking. Some of you might be using groundnut oil, coconut oil, olive oil, the rice bran oil. There are so many oils that are present in the market. So all these things, what are they? Butter. All these are what? All these are the examples of the fats. Once you are eating them, what you are doing? You are increasing the amount of the fat in your body. Now another thing that you have to keep in mind is that when we go for fasting, suppose it is Ramadan, month of Ramadan, or it is any sacred festival of the Janmashtami or Mahashivratri. What do the people do? They go for fasting. When you are fasting, what is, you are not eating anything, right? When you are not eating anything, but your body is still working, it is requiring energy because your heart is pumping, blood is running through your body, you are respirating, that is, you are inhaling oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide. You are continuously thinking. So all these activities requires what? Energy. And you have not eaten anything since the morning. What happens by the evening? You feel lazy, right? We start feeling lazy. Why? because we have not eaten anything. The energy that was stored in our body has literally finished off by that time. And if we have not, if that fasting continues for few days, then what will happen? The person will become weak. Why? Because all the energy that is stored in the form of a fats will reduce down, and the person will become thin. And that is why all the people who are fat, they go for dieting. When they diet, the extra amount of the layer of the fat that is deposited under the skin, it dissolves, it melts down, and the person automatically becomes thin. Now, when we talk about the vitamins, they are very important. Why they are important? If we do not have the vitamins, then what will happen with us? It is required for the proper functioning of the organs of the body. It is required for the proper functioning of the organs. Proper functioning. Right? So, if we are talking about the vitamins, vitamins are very important. Now, when we talk about the vitamins, there are two types of vitamins. One is the fat soluble. Fat. And other is the water soluble. Now, when we talk about the fat solubles, they are vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. Now, when we talk about the water soluble, it is B complex. Why I am writing here B complex? It is because there are a lot of B vitamins, B1, B2, B3, B6, B12. So, these are what? When we take them together, it is termed as a B complex, along with vitamin C. They are water soluble. So, water soluble means once you have eaten any citrus fruit, like vitamin C is, all the citrus fruits are rich in vitamin C. When you are eating it, like in these pandemic, it was said that eating a lot of vitamin C will help. So, what the people did, they purchased a lot of oranges from the market and they start eating it. But you know one thing, because it is water soluble, what happens? All the oranges that you have eaten, and once you go to the washroom, all the vitamin that is not absorbed by the body is automatically cleaned up from our body. So they are not stable, they are not staying in our body for a longer duration, right? On the other hand, if we talk about the fat soluble vitamins like A, D, E, and K, they will stay in your body for a longer time because they are not eliminated out of the body as easily as water soluble vitamins are. Vitamins are also responsible for the immune system of our body. Now, when we talk about the minerals, it is about the muscles, it is about the bones, it is about the organs that we have in our body, like the heart and the other organs. These minerals are very much important. Why? Because if these minerals are not there, the density of the bone will become weak. If the minerals are not there, the muscles will not develop as they will develop in spite of having a lot of proteins. But if the minerals are not there, then what will happen? It will not grow properly. Right? So, minerals also have their own role to play. Now, when we talk about the minerals, just like the vitamins, they are also of two types. Now, these are also of two types. One is the macro minerals. What are macro minerals? Those minerals that are required in a larger amount by the body. Larger amount by the body. Like, if we talk about calcium, phosphorus, they are the examples of the macro minerals. We require them more because if you talk about the toothpaste, it is always saying that it has a lot of calcium in it. If we talk about the teeth, our teeth can be in good condition only if we have good amount of calcium, or bones, calcium, right? So that is macro minerals. The other type of minerals are trace minerals. Now, when we talk about the trace, it means they are required in a very small amount. Very small amount. All the nutrients that are required in a very small amount by the body, which fall under the category of minerals, are termed as the trace minerals. Like, we have iodine in the salt. Iodine. Like iron. Nickel. All these are the elements that are required. These are the type of the minerals that are required in very less amount in our body. Right? Iodine is mixed in the salt. So, we do not require iodine from any other sources. Once we have take the salt that is having an adequate amount of iodine, that is fulfilling our need, body need. So, what is the amount of the salt that we use? It is, it may vary from person to person, but the salt you intake is very less. Right, therefore they are termed as the trace minerals. Now, when we talk about the roughage, the example of roughage is salads. All the greens that can be eaten raw without cooking them, that is termed as a salad. Like if we talk about the onions, tomatoes, if we talk about the cucumber, right, radish, all these are what? These are the type of salads. They are used in the preparation of the salad, right? So roughage is doing what? It is increasing the digestion system of a body, digestion capacity of our body. All the things that we are eating, all the five things that we are eating, they go to the digestive system of our body, that is in the small intestine, large intestine, that is the part of our digestive system. Once they reach there, what happens? They are absorbed. These nutrients, whatever food stuff we have eaten, these are absorbed from that food stuff. And if we have a good digestion system, what will it do? It will utilize all these components that are present in the food that we have eaten. As a result, whatever we are eating, we will get the nutrient, and accordingly our body will start growing. You might have seen some people, they are eating a lot, right? Some of you might be suffering from this problem, that you are eating a lot but your body is not growing in comparison to the other people. Some people are eating only one chapati or two parathas a day, right, at a time, and you might be eating four parathas or three parathas, but still you are comparatively weaker in comparison to the person who is eating two parathas. Why? This is just because your digestive system is not working properly. So what you have to do is, in this case, you have to increase the roughage. Once you increase the roughage portion, then your digestion will become stronger, and once it becomes stronger, then all the food that you are eating, it will be absorbed properly by the body, and you will get all these nutrients, thereby you will grow healthier. Water is another very important aspect. Now, it is normally said that we should consume at least 7 to 8 glasses of water. Why? Because it maintains the pH level of our body. It maintains the metabolic activities that are going in our body. If water is not there, we can survive without food. But if you are keeping fasting without water, it becomes very hard. Why? Because water is doing what? It is maintaining our blood pressure also. It is very much important. Without water, we cannot imagine our life. So water is also very important. Now all these things, when you take in a proper ratio, then it is termed as a balanced diet. What it is termed as? It is termed as a balanced diet. Now when we talk about the balanced diet can be defined as a right amount of the nutrition that is absorbed by the body. Right amount of the nutrition that is required by the body, that is termed as a balanced diet. I hope all the components, all the nutrients, roughage and water is clear to you, balanced diet is clear to you. Thank you.